Welcome back. I haven't done a channel update in a while, so I thought I'd take some time and just, you know, talk to you guys. Hey, what's up? How are you guys doing? This is random footage, by the way, so feel free to dab out if you'd like. In the last episode of About Time, I talked about how I found out that I had an Asian trait because I was taking medication that wasn't working for years. So I was like slowly degrading health-wise when I should have been getting better. So now that I know that I have this trait and I'm taking the proper medicine for my race, I'm getting better. So I'm going through the slow process of recovery for my lungs from triple pneumonia, which I mentioned that I had a while back. I apologize for my scratchy voice. One of the drawbacks of building up my lungs is that initially it causes me to cough. So it's messing with my voice. So I apologize for that. I think I mentioned that I found out this summer that I have a sister. Well, let me rephrase that. I always knew I had a sibling, but my sibling finally found me because I've been very vocal about the fact that I was pretty sure that I had a sibling. But when I tried to tell people when I was younger, no one except the people on my mom's side of the family believed me due to the persona that my father had. They couldn't believe, you know, that there'd be this child right there, right up under the nose, and, you know, never believed it. My sister, whose name is Tori, took the ancestry DNA test because she was working on her family tree. And the last name of my family came up instead of her father's family. So nothing was matching up, so she asked her mother, and that's how the truth finally came out. I'm not gonna lie, I finally feel vindicated. The desire to tell some people a big fuck you is strong. I'm not even gonna lie. Because people are now being forced to re-evaluate their wrong conclusion on why my father and I didn't see eye to eye on things, because it's not like I didn't bring this up to my dad, but for his reasons, he just, you know, never said anything, never fully admitted it, but he would leave enough of a trail for me to be suspicious. You know what I mean? So the truth, you know, it eventually comes to light. And one thing that I'm finding as I get older is that that truth really comes to light after you die. So think about that legacy that you want to leave behind. Because I'm noticing with my parents and other people, it's just like you learn a completely different side of them after they die. It's weird. So yeah, I have a sister and she's cool. I haven't met her yet. Although we live like 15 minutes from each other. We talk just about every day though. And the reason why is because my lungs are weak. I haven't been outside all summer. I haven't been outside. We won't even talk about the last time I've been outside because it's hard for me to breathe. The minute I step outside, and I know you're thinking it's like, well, time it's air, you know, it's the same air outside as it is inside. No, it's not. It's really not. I tried stepping outside and all the smells is just like overwhelming, and I just start coughing ridiculously. So I've been inside. I want to get out and play. So I'm working hard, relearning how to breathe, basically. So let's see what else. Oh, I mentioned on Twitter and Facebook that my cat Chloe was diagnosed with vestibular disease. And basically what happens with that is that she lost the ability to control her movements and her sense of perception. This strikes really fast. And It is very easy to mistake this for stroke symptoms. But the good news is that if your cat or dog, found out dogs have this too, get this, they can completely recover. It's scary. I, as a pet owner, I watched her turn into a vegetable, literally. On Friday, she lost all ability to walk, hold up her head. Just a complete vegetable. Monday, she's walking around. I'm not even joking. So I will probably talk about this more because the few people that I mentioned it to, because I normally don't talk about things as I'm going through them, and I'm trying to change that because it makes me reclusive, and I don't think that's a positive thing, because life, you go through shit with life, you know? And one of the valued experiences that I've had is that particularly with pneumonia, playing Eve, somebody told me, I can hear in your voice that you have pneumonia. I don't care what the doctor says, get another doctor. So you go through things, and that's how you connect with people. So I don't want to be that reclusive person that talks about everything after it happened. Your pet can recover from this. So I'm going to spread awareness about it because the people that I have talked about it have never heard of it before. And it is extremely scary to see your loved one turn into a vegetable for, like, no reason. So my gameplay schedule has been whacked due to that, plus, you know, my medical thing. But, and she definitely caught something previous to that because she wasn't eating normally. And she was secluding herself, which caused me, you know, to really look at things. My daughter, you know, she was like, okay, what is going on? It was like, Chloe would hide up under my bed. She'd just be under my bed. And she's usually like right up under me. So as long as there are no underlying conditions, most pets recover fully, or they may have a slight tilt to their head, but it doesn't stop them from having a wonderful quality of life. So I cringe thinking on how many animals were misdiagnosed and put to sleep because they thought that they, you know, that these were stroke symptoms. So I definitely want to bring awareness to that. Gaming-wise, what's up with the channel? Well, you know, Eve Online is going free to play in November, November 8th, and I will definitely be there for that because I miss my mom. I haven't been playing, but I keep up with what's going on in the game. Now, how successful this transition to free-to-play will be, I don't know. Players like me, who have lots of ships and skill points, are going to be restricted from flying them without a subscription. So, for long-term play, how appealing is that? Now, it would be appealing if the underlying problems as to why players left in the first place were resolved. But, for the most part, they're still there. So even if you felt inclined to resub, how long would they stay? You see what I'm saying? And the problem is that DCP has I can't focus itis and ends up focusing on other things instead of really just laser focusing on Eve, fixing it and improving it and then moving on, you know, to branch out from there. But, and don't say, you know, there's not problems with Eve because they have a retention problem, which is why they're doing this in the first place. So obviously there is a problem. So don't say that there's not, because it is. So it'll be interesting to see how this pans out. Honestly, I think the quick fix would have been if Plex wasn't so expensive. I mean, it's $1 billion. Come on now. So if it was less expensive, I think that it would be more, there would be more people in the game. It's not fun to have to farm ISK just to be able to play. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah. What else? I have a surprise coming up for Halloween. So we're not going to talk about that. And we're going to move on to the next thing. Mass Effect and Bioware games. There is no easy way to say it. I think I'm going to play Bioware games as a male character. I want to try it. See, the problem is I tend to think like a male more than a female. You know, like those, here's a perfect example. This is one of the reasons why I will probably be single for life. Guy asks you, hey, how you doing? And I say, I'm fine. Because of previous relationships, when I say I'm fine, or no, go hang out with your boys, it's okay, have a good time, or whatever, I don't care, you know, whatever you want to do, or look, I don't like Valentine's Day. I mean, not that I don't like it, it's just that I feel like Valentine's sweetest day, you know, I feel like if I'm treating you right, 365, then that's a meaningless day. So, I don't really care. So, don't get me anything on Valentine's Day or Sweetest Day because we're already handling our business 365. Or if I say, you know what, I'm really not in the wedding ring. You know, I don't really need, you know, like that big engagement ring. You know, that $30 gold ring is cool because, honestly, I really don't care about the wedding. What I care about is the day that you ask me to share your life with you. That is the big day to me. Yeah. So when I say stuff like that, guys never believe. So I have to unprogram the stupid out of their brain because of the stupid shit they went through before me. Yes, I said stupid because a lot of that shit really is stupid. Say what you mean what you say, and it just makes life so much easier. So anyway, that's why I say I tend to be more like a male than a female. Like at a party, I don't want to sit with the girls. I want to sit with the guys playing the games. You see what I'm saying? So, the overwhelming problem is that male characters, and when I say overwhelmingly, I mean that shit, have better love interest and scripted options than female characters. I think I would have enjoyed Dragon Age Inquisition much better if I had played as a man and, like, romance Cassandra. Okay, let's grow. We're just going to talk about sex. Let's just... and I'm not... Screw it. Okay, yeah, I'm not getting distracted. Let's talk about the kiss, okay? What kind of kiss is the Cullen kiss?
Come on.
My tune obviously doesn't know what a hug is. What the hell? I mean, I've got nothing. When I saw that, I was just like frozen in place. It's like, this can't be happening. And then the sex scene. Oh my God. I was
Cullen,
horrified.
You
know I have a zero tolerance for bad sex anyway. Okay? Zero tolerance. I mean, it started off good. It started off hot, actually. Slide the stuff off the table. And then it shows you in the bed, and my tomb is completely clothed. What the hell? Good sex doesn't work that way. No, 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 no. They have this tender moment when they say, I love you. And my tomb is completely dressed.
I love you.
My character is a cold bitch. I was like in shock. My tune finally gets to be with Cullen because you know that shit should have happened in Dragon Age Origins. And she doesn't even act right. What happened in Dragon Age 2? Fenris fell in love with my tune, right? They have the sex scene. Then he freaks out. And then he leaves. How long did he leave? 2 to 3 years. And then my character is in a... Okay. Then they meet back up again.
We'll
and
together.
Then he's like, I'm
that
sorry.
That is my hope as well. We have never discussed what happened between us 3 years ago.
You didn't want to talk about it.
I felt like a fool. I thought it better if you hated me. I deserve no less.
Wait a minute.
It isn't better. That night, I remember your touch as if it were yesterday.
Wait, what?
I should have asked your forgiveness long ago. I hope you can forgive me now.
You, we haven't since three?
I always understood.
Oh.
If there is a future to be had, I will walk into it gladly at your side.
And then my tune is like, it's okay. No problem. No, there's a definite problem. Definite problem there. I mean, it was an interesting storyline, but there was no depth to it. You know what I mean? Then what happened with the Severin? What happened with him? He was like, I love you in Dragon Age Origin, but I'm afraid to say it. Again, an interesting storyline with no depth to it. Now, I haven't played through Mass Effect 1. I own it, but I haven't played through it all. I haven't gotten very far in it, actually. But in Mass Effect 2, I played all the way through. And I finally get the sexy guy as a girl, too, because Jacob is the business. Oh, I was so happy. It's like, finally. And I remember feeling the male romance options had better stories, but I don't remember what all of those are, which is why I'm looking forward to playing through it, because it's almost like a blind playthrough because I just don't remember. I remember that I didn't like my ending. I remember that. I was trying to go for perfect, but now I don't go for perfect because shit happens, you know? So then what happens in Mass Effect 3? Now, I did not play Mass Effect 3. Because I found out very early on that Jacob moved on. And I was like, fuck. Mass Effect, what? Between that and the messed up ending, I was done. I was done. Jacob's like, what? You expect me to wait forever? And I was like, I bet Liara did, you piece of shit. Oh my God. Girls, jacked again. There is sexual dysfunction in Bioware games for girl characters. There, I said it. It's there. It's a thing. Anyway, I decided that I think I would enjoy, that I will enjoy Bioware games more playing as a male. But you may have noticed, I don't sound like a man. So I was confused on how to do that. Not only with Mass Effect games, but there are a lot of games where the default is a male character, like Deus Ex Human Revolution. Deus Ex, period, you know? So, I think I figured it out. So, I've downloaded Mass Effect 1. I bought Mass Effect 3 because, you know, that ending and Jacob. So, I did buy them. So, now I have them all. It's a go because I'm looking forward to Andromeda. I love Bioware games, don't get me wrong, but I think the disconnect is that I was playing them as a female character. So what do you guys think? Can you tolerate me playing as a male character? Do you even care what gender I play? I mean, it's like I said, it's one of the reasons why I haven't even played through Deus Ex Human Revolution, because I feel like I'm cheating if I play through something and I don't put something up on the channel. Isn't that horrible? So there's a zillion games that I'd like to play, but I don't want to be pigeonholed into playing female characters because I'm a girl. You know what I mean? I mean, it's something that I did as myself. I want to make it clear that I have never heard from a viewer a preference one way or another about gender. The only thing I've ever heard as far as characters is why my characters aren't always black from people of color. And that's another area that I want freedom on because, okay, the truth is that, you know, I recently found out I'm Blaucasian. So I'm part black, part white, part Asian. And that is reflected in my family because in my family, I have very pale people to very dark people. and I tend to make my characters based on family features with family members. I really want to break away from that and create characters based on what I'm feeling at the moment and give them a unique identity, a unique story, and throw myself into the game. I don't want to only play good characters either, which is what I tended to do based on my own personality, but I just want to have fun with the story. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes, you know, like I found playing the Star Wars online game, I felt good because it just felt right doing the bad thing, you know, because it just felt like the right decision at that time. So that's what I want to do. So what do you guys think about that? Let me know in the comments. And just thinking about that has renewed my passion for gaming. I have Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2, and 2 being the Sith Lords. Would you believe I haven't played through the Witcher series? I have 1 and 2, and I swore I was not buying 3 until I played through 1 and 2. I tried playing 1, and man, that's going to take some practice. I have to buff up my playing skills a bit for that one. But it's a challenge. I wanna do that. Because the story is badass. It's a badass story. I downloaded Enderal, the mod for Skyrim, and I want to play through that. And that's another game I haven't played through. Would you believe I haven't played through Skyrim? No. I'm finishing up the Elder Scrolls Online story because the plot twists in that is real. You may have noticed because the playlist for it is public, but the videos are private, that I've been uploading videos for that. It is a no commentary playthrough. And the reason why I may start making those public now is because it's a time for me to give my voice a rest while my body adjusts to these workouts. So it's a way to put a story up on the channel that I definitely wanted to finish and minimize my speaking. Not to say that I'm not going to speak because, EVE Online. So, I thought that between the two, it would be a good balance. I have been playing ARK, but I mentioned in a blog post, actually, where it's coming to the time where the game is supposed to be released. I want to see it released. I do not want to encourage people to play when I am not 100% sure that their focus is on the main game because they've proved otherwise too many times. And I'm not going the CCP route twice. So, you will see a video from me because I did something completely bad. My badassery is on fleek in that game right now. You can't tell me shit. You cannot tell me shit. Wait till you see what I did. So, I will be putting up a video about that, but and you're seeing some ARK footage now, most likely. I haven't decided what I'm going to put behind here, but most likely ARK, most likely the Quetzal, that 48 hours, every hour and a half, 2 hours. Yeah, I beat the game. Let's be clear. I beat the fucking game when we're not even going to talk about that, because that mechanic is so fucked up. Having me log in to do an interaction is not a challenge. I beat the game with that shit. Let's be real clear with that. So, telling me to log in to do something is nothing to me. I see, it could be a challenge for other people, but it ain't shit to me. So when, the way the mechanic is, since I started ranting about this, is that it's RNG as to whether you can get the full bonus or not. So you can actually be there, log in, and then your pet has grown up while you were gone. Because it grew. You could stay there, but the interaction is just going to grow up before the interaction timer goes because they're not synced properly. Stupid. It is so stupid. I hate games that waste my time. Because the truth is, time is more valuable than money because time is something that cannot be remade. That second, can't get it back. So when I log in and I clear my schedule to log in to do something and I can't fucking do it, oh, breathe. So yeah, my love-hate relationship with ARK continues. Wow, quick update. Until I can fly, you will not see me in Legion. I am putting my foot down on that shit. Shit is the word tonight, I guess. One of the problems that I have with WoW is I feel like in the beginning, you could tell that my character was becoming a badass. You know, I looked forward to gaining new spells, new abilities, even if they were very niche things, because it gave me options. And maybe that's why Elder Scrolls, I'm loving it so much, because I have freaking options. Even though I don't have buttons, I have freaking options. You know what I'm saying? With WoW, my tune is supposedly more powerful, but is more stupid. You know, it's like my character forgot everything, and I just have a problem with that. And then add on to it, you know, you don't really get new spells, new abilities, or anything. You just get more buffed, you know, so to speak. I like new shit. I'm not even gonna lie. So, when you tell me that I can't fly, I would be cool with it if, in the beginning of the game, when the expansion launched, it told me what I would have to unlock for when the time comes that I can fly, so that I could be working on it at my own pace, in my own time. I'd be cool with that. I'd be in Legion right now. But that doesn't happen. They tell you the unlocks when almost close to when the expansion ends. So that means I have to go back through the fucking zones. I hated that in Draenor. I hated it because I missed things. And I didn't enjoy going back there to finish so that I could fly. You see what I'm saying? I did not get any joy out of that. So since I know I'm not going to get any joy out of that, I figure I'll just wait. If I get Legion, I'm not going to play through it. There's no point. I just don't see the point in it. So what I might do is purchase it. And it won't be before the holidays, because I've got too many other things that I want to play. I'm still subscribed to the game, don't get me wrong, because there's a lot of things that I haven't done in the game. It's just that I just don't see myself. I'm just not inclined. I mean, Legion is good. It is good. I played through it with the beta. So if you're not one to mind the flying thing and going back through the zones, I strongly suggest Legion, because it is a huge improvement. I'm not even going to front. It is a huge improvement. But I know my personality. And my personality is, I need to know what those unlocks are. Otherwise, I'm going to get real frustrated. And I don't want to go through what I went through before with Draenor. I learned a lesson there. It was not fun. It was the worst grind ever. So, going through those zones, knowing what I have to do, and exploring, that's fun. That's my fun. That's my joy. So, I'm one of those that gives Blizzard income after the fact. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I'm looking forward to it, but on my own terms. Guess what? I've talked enough. So that's it for this one. Let me know what you think about me playing male characters. I'm most likely going to do it because I think like a male. And to be honest, a lot of times playing a female character, I ended up acting like a male too. How many times was I playing a girl talking about ass? Girls ass, you know? Not to say that you can't do that under a girl character. You know, I'm not saying that you can't. And you know what? You know, I may actually play a lesbian character. I might actually do that. I don't know what I'm going to do. I just know that I'm going to have fun. And my virtual dick as a male is going to be satisfied. Because there was no satisfaction in with my tunes. It just wasn't. And I'm going to fix that. So I just want to open up and just throw myself into the story and make custom scenes like I did for Dragon Age Inquisition. Imagine the fun that I can have when there's more to work with. You know what I'm saying? So, okay, really, this is it for this one. I just miss talking to you guys. So, yeah. Okay. All right. That's it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.